guys, so the other day when I showed you guys how I was setting up my little backdrop for my videos, a couple of people asked me like what my setup looked like. So this is a overview. I do film in a basement, that's why you guys will see the window from time to time in the corner. But I film with the Canon 70D. Keep in mind, this video is not going to be in depth of the stuff that I use to record. It's just going to be like a quick little brief overview. So I use the Canon 70D to record. I use the Canon 50mm lens with the 1.8 f-stop. If you guys are into cameras, you will know what I'm talking about. This ring light is a ring light that will be maybe featured in my line. I'm not sure if I'm going to sell this, but I love this ring light. I don't need to use a diffuser to diffuse my light. This controls the kind of light. So the light can be yellow, it can be orange, it can be warm, bright. There's no way for me to actually show you guys because you're not actually gonna see it on the camera. And this just controls how bright the light is. And then you can save different channels. That's why it says channel one. And then when you come around, when you first come around, right here is my drawers that I keep some of my palettes. The palettes that I reach for most of the time, I keep them in these drawers. They are a mess. And then obviously this is the backdrop that I showed you guys the other day. Down here I just keep my other diffuser, the little holder, the little baggy things for my softbox lights, and then that's my camera bag that I take with me when I travel. And then obviously you guys saw this, and then this drawer just holds pretty much my hair stuff, like any little miscellaneous hair things that I need, like hair dye, little things are in there, mad random stuff. And then this is just me in my full body mirror. That's me. And then as far as this area, I have the typical beauty guru setup. Two softbox lights. The reason I have the diffuser over this light is simply because I want my name sign to be visible, and this light tends to make the sign look too bright. And then obviously this is the backdrop that I showed you guys the other day. Down here I just keep my other diffuser, the little holder, the little baggy things for my softbox lights, and then that's my camera bag that I take with me when I travel. And then obviously you guys saw this. And then this drawer just holds pretty much my hair stuff, like any little miscellaneous hair things that I need, like hair dye, little things are in there, mad random stuff. And then this is just me in my full body mirror. That's me. And then as far as this area, I have the typical beauty guru setup. Two softbox lights. The reason I have the diffuser over this light is simply because I want my name sign to be visible, and this light tends to make the sign look too bright. This is my desk. I do have two mirrors. I don't like this mirror anymore. It just pretty much sits here. It looks so gross. It just sits there. I use this one because it's easier for me to see. I just got done filming, so it does have a lot of makeup on it. And then this is just an old TV that was around my house that I used, and I was like, I can get a HDMI. I was like, I can get an HDMI cord. What am I saying? This is an old TV that I was just like sitting around my house. So I grabbed it and I was like, I'm gonna get an HDMI cord and hook it up to my camera and make it a monitor. So this is my monitor. And then this is just the desk. I actually got this desk off of someone that was leaving last semester for $20. This desk is huge. So you really just have to work with what you have. And then these are my makeup brushes that I reach for all the time. right here. And when I'm done filming, I do like to clean up the desk because most of the time it's so much makeup like cocked up on the desk. So I just wipe it down. And then this is my ring light. Obviously the camera's on the other side. You guys can see it because the ring light is blurring it.
So a couple people asked, so I just wanted to show you guys. Again, I do film in a basement. I'm literally making it do what it do. If you want to do something, just literally do it. Work with what you have. Don't try to, you know, be extra and buy all the stuff. Work with what you have. You know, I kind of gradually got all these things over a period of time. So my advice to you guys is to work with what you have and make it do what it do. I'm in a basement. This is not the typical beauty room. Many people have an actual bedroom for their beauty area. I do not. So I utilize my basement. The space that I had, I made it do what it do. Like, so my message to y'all is, get out of your head. If you want to do something, just do it.
You have to be your biggest fan. And when things are really tough and they're really rough and nothing's working.
The next day.
Hey guys. Hey. It's Friday. I'm on my way to Maryland or Virginia. I don't know. Maryland, Virginia, same little area. I'm going to Ari's half birthday party. I have my scarf on because I don't feel good. And typically I like to be cute in the airport, but it wasn't happening. So yeah, I'm on my way. I should be there in like an hour. The flight is only 50 minutes long. And yeah, so that's what we're doing. When I get there, I will show you guys, everyone. But I did want to come up and just tell y'all what we're doing. What we're doing. Ari. Hi, Mama. Hi. Hi, Mama. No? Okay. You want to get in the vlog? And of course, this fucking alcoholic over there.
Come on, let's get on that
song. Duh, she be drooling. Matthias, I like your jacket.
Thank you.
Okay, guys, Ari's aunties, period. Let me stop. Look, how the fuck the music playing? They not even in the car.
It just connected.
Ooh, hold on, y'all. This not it? Oh, this is it. This is it. This is it. All right. Cause that A Boogie not about to copyright me, but Ari's aunties is looking like a snack. Period. I have not been vlogging, guys, because I genuinely do not feel good. Like, I feel like shit. I thought I was gonna get through the entire winter without getting sick, but apparently not. So yeah, so I have like literally I've been putting hand sanitizers on my hands, I've been washing my hands, and still I'm sick. So what are we gonna do? But we're on our way to Ariana's half birthday party. You know, black people mad extra, half birthday, like, who does that? But you know, I'm here for it. The extra aunties are here, period. And yeah, we're about to head there. I literally feel like shit. Like, I genuinely feel like shit. I think I uploaded one time this week, and it was literally because I don't feel good. Like, I have content, but to edit is just too much for me right now. So I'm not gonna do that. As you guys can see, I sound crazy, I feel crazy. I took a couple shots, it helped me. Drank some African soup, helped. But right now, I don't feel too good. Y'all wanna see Auntie Talia? She look mad cute and her ass is fat. The vlog.
Hey guys,
please. Oh my god, Talia Avante.
I'll figure out. I look cute.
Let me stop.
I just need something for my
Shayla sense. Be like, she stay having someone record her.
No funny. No, I don't need this. I need
me something for my sinuses.
I put too much lotion on my hand.
And I sound like shit.
I'm gonna wash your vagina, bitches.
Yo, I did left my tenant in the house, so I think I forgot something.
Great, we're at the venue. Y'all, I had to stop at CVS to get something because I was having a lot of sinus pressure. Yeah, I am. Oh, hold on. Let me show Talise. Turn around. We want to see your ass. That's what we want to see. Okay. Period. Yes. Okay. The other auntie. What's in your cup?
This is a shot.
A shot of what?
This ain't a shot. This is like two shots. But mm-hmm.
Of what? Okay, of course. Okay, the other aunt. Come on, in the light. Let's see. Turn around. We want to see the ass. We want to see all of that. Take the jacket off. The glow. Okay. Okay. Okay.
We're the best looking aunties here. Period.
Period.
Okay. They all legit. We like fake. You know, we like friends of the father, but still aunties. What you talk about? Matthias only got one sister. She mad young. She can't be a real auntie right now, you know? She can't do real auntie things. Like,
my sister changed her diaper.
Bro, y'all see them? They looking fine. Talise with the fatty, TK with the glow. Like, we didn't ask about the henny though.
I want to.
Yeah, did you make the stuff? No.
Okay.
Where did they go though? I don't see them in the car. Are they still in there?
Yeah, they just got tits. Thais got him a shirt.
Yeah, so you know, shop that good old chocolate. Look at it. Love to see it. Love to see it.
Yo, I need to learn this dance.
And the other one is.
What are you making, ma'am?
Not when I'm on the color.
Now, come on. Just take it out. We know you, okay? Uh-huh. All right, what else?
And the key ingredient.
I need you to take out what's in the bag. Why you hiding? No, go ahead. Take it out. Show them what's in the bag. Hi, mama.
Don't
show
them my food.
Hi. Hi, pretty girl. Nobody asked you to dance yet.
I'm not dancing.
All right, she's not. They tired of seeing you. All right.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, what else? Matthias, what she look like holding your jacket?
Well, I wasn't. I was trying to put it on there so he didn't put icing on it. Okay.
She said, I ain't even trying to pay for nobody's stuff.
Right?
Hi, guys. Hi, Ari's mom. Hi, Ari's auntie.
This is me, auntie. We out here.
Get her, please.
Right, Puddin?
Yeah. Puddin is not even paying us no attention. She being mad stitch today. I don't know what's going on. What's going on? Okay, she don't fuck with me. She won't let me get a good picture with her. I can't, but I got good pictures with her. So that's all real bougie, okay? We like that energy already. Okay?
You made me a kid. She belongs to me. Thank you.
Thank you for making my kid. Taking her home with me.
Take her.
Gotta take Ari gifts. Is that okay, Queen? Do I have 5 minutes to put
the
gift on?
Yeah, you do.
Okay.
I'm ready to go though. I don't feel good.
clean
it. We don't care.
If you don't,
I'm not, no, not like that. Like, I'm fine now. You see how she tried to play me? Talk about throw up. I didn't do that. That was one time.
I was gonna clean it up, but I was gonna let you know about yourself.
Nick said I was gonna let you. I was gonna clean it up, but I was gonna let you know about yourself. Excuse me, ma'am. You took very long. Yo, you see? How was the party? How was the party, boo?
I'm cold
too. I thought y'all Virginians or Virginia. We in Virginia, right? Mm-hmm. You know, because when you were in the Maryland DMV area, you just be hopping from state to state. You be going from DC to Delaware to Maryland. It just be real ghetto. But
all right, girls, we are no longer safe. He took the gun.
He did?
Yeah.
He was in the car? Mm-hmm. Oh, wow. Oh,
okay. Okay. Nigga took the gun off the car.
Yo, get it together.
Cause people be acting up, and you might have to.
Yo, I feel like shit, y'all.
Okay.
Bro, let me tell you something. These seats.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, when I sit in my car, I always put my jacket before I sit down. Cause it's really for the look. That's what leather seats are for. Because in the summertime.
I didn't think it would be that bad because I put this here, but.
Nah, bro. The summertime, it be mad hot. And in the winter, it be mad cold. Like, that's why I like the spring. Ooh, I look good. Ari's half birthday was, it was cute.
Got it.
I got it.
I will come.
This is so pretty. They be wildin'. I don't know why they do that.
This is how the party turned out. My sister's milk drunk with her piece of chicken.
Post at all last week because I had the flu and I felt horrible, guys. Like, when I went, I ended up going to urgent care when I got off the flight. I don't know if you guys could see that in the last clip. Wow, I just put my car in sport. Let me fix this because I'm doing a lot right now. Hold on. I put my seatbelt on. So many people around. Like, what is going on? I guess it's because it's Saturday, but.
So, in the last clip, you guys saw me literally getting on and off the plane because we deplaned literally 3 times. We had to get off the plane and get back on the plane just for like different reasons. I think the first reason was because something was wrong with the plane. Why? Oh, that's why I still feel cold air. I'm like, what the hell? Okay, so. We had to get off the plane literally 3 times. The first time was because something was wrong with the plane. The plane was giving some type of emergency signal. And I was super happy about that because if the pilot wasn't paying attention, God knows what could have happened. And then so many people were complaining. And I don't know if it's just me and my mindset evolving and just changing, but I saw that as a blessing. At the end of the day, if the pilot wasn't paying attention, who knows what could have happened. You know, we could have taken off and crashed or something. Like, I was just so grateful that he was paying attention. I'm like, you know, it is gonna delay me, which is annoying, but I'm safe. You know, I have a life. You know, God looked out for us, and that's all that matters. So that's what I was happy about. But then the second time, they told us we were going to another plane. First of all, they said the plane would be taking off in like the next 20 minutes. It was like, I think the next gate over. So we had to get out, go through that gate, whatever, whatever, and go to the next plane. We go to the next plane. We don't board that plane till like 40 minutes later. So we finally board the plane. We get on the plane and they're like, oh, they didn't do a security check before we got on the plane. And at this point, I'm just like, okay. You know, the first time it was cool. Second, y'all dragging it. All right, so we get off the plane, get back on. The third time, I'm trying to think what happened the third time. I can't even remember why we got off the plane at the third time.
they had to do something else on the plane the third time. And at that point, I was over it because I could feel my body like getting weaker. And it was definitely because obviously I had the flu. I just didn't know yet. And I was just like over it. And then when I got to the airport here, my bags were taking forever. Like everyone's bags, just the bags were taking forever to get off the plane. And then when it finally gets off, I was so happy. Like when I finally saw the bags coming through, my bag was the first bag. I grabbed it and I dipped. And I was feeling like shit, but I'm so used to just laying in bed, letting my body get over things. And I'm just so used to that. I was going to do that, but I was feeling like very off. And with this coronavirus and all this craziness going around, I was like, let me go to urgent care and make sure nothing is actually wrong. So I go to urgent care. All I thought was I had strep throat because I also lost my voice, so I couldn't talk till Friday. So I'm thinking, all right, I have strep throat. They're gonna give me something for it. I'm gonna go home. I'll be fine. She comes back. She's like, no, you're negative for strep, but you have the flu. I was like, oh, okay. And then she's like, oh, and we have this test for the coronavirus, so they're gonna give me like a note for work or whatever so I can be out for the rest of the week. So this is Monday now. And literally the entire week I was just in bed. Like I felt so bad. Like I had no energy because I couldn't eat. I had no energy because I literally didn't have an appetite. And then when I finally got an appetite, everything was hurting my stomach. It was just a mess, y'all. It was a freaking mess. And I just didn't have motivation to edit. I didn't have motivation literally for nothing because I was sick. And typically when I'm sick, I try to push myself to at least do something and be productive. But I was like, listen, let me take this time, breathe. Because this could be another reason, you know, I'm out here getting sick because I don't give myself breathing time and I'm just always on the go. So the week was honestly great. Although I was like sick, I got to just rest, you know, be lazy. I wouldn't even say it's laziness. I just got to rest and really just take that needed time to myself and relax. So the whole week, I didn't go to work, I didn't edit, I didn't do anything, literally nothing. I just lay down because I had 103 degree fever and my body was aching. As you guys know, when you have the flu, your body just aches. So that's what I did this week. This is like one of the days. It's Saturday now. I'm actually finally feeling like myself. I'm almost at 100%. And I decided that I would get up and go shoot some content. You know, I haven't gotten anything done this week, so I was excited to just get up and go shoot some content. So I did record this makeup look, and then I met up with Angel and we took a couple of pictures. I'm just hoping that I have some good ones in there. I think I do though. You know how like you glance at them and you're like, okay, I have something. We're gonna go do that. And yeah, it's gonna be like an exciting next couple of weeks though, because I am going to Puerto Rico for Affirmation, and that I'm expecting that vlog to be split up into like two, maybe three, because I don't want it to be like no longer than like 15 minutes each. So I'm thinking like two or three different vlogs. I'm gonna do a pack with me. I'm gonna do a prep with me for vacation, you know, getting my hair done, my nails done. I'm not sure if I'm gonna get my lashes done just yet because I really don't like getting my lashes done because I can't wash my face properly. Like, I get all in there. I hate to be like limited to like, oh, I have to wash around. So I haven't decided on my lashes. I think I'm gonna pretty much end this part, this vlog here. You guys will see me in this makeup for the beginning of the next vlog, so beware. But I'm gonna end this vlog here. Thank you guys so much for supporting me. Thank you for watching my videos. Just thank you. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.